comes the sun. Here comes the sun. I say it's all right.
This is Polly, and the year is 1811. Polly just gave birth to her first son, John Humphrey Noyes, who would go on to change American history forever. Because of this woman, utopian societies were no longer tempted, and advocating for women's rights was finally gaining momentum. And who is this strapping young lad, you may ask? Well, this is John Humphrey Noyes, the leader of the Oneida community. And without him, we would have no tale to tell today. As a boy, John was quite rebellious, and refused to study religion even though his mother urged him to do so. Instead, John wanted to play. Look at John play. Look at John play with the stick. You found the stick, John. As John went through the Second Great Awakening, he found no interest in Charles Finney and other such ministers, to his mother's great disappointment. His mother sent him to the Yale School of Divinity in hopes he would learn to love religion. Instead, John quickly got a cold and figured he was being punished by God for his lack of religious fervor. Noyes was determined to change his ways now and deeply invested his time in religious studies and even developed his own beliefs such as perfectionism, the thought that everyone is sinless after conversion. His blasphemous ideas were then published in the paper and he was denied ordination. John now had a mental breakdown and his long-distance love interest Abigail Merwin broke up with him via letter. So shallow. But John was determined to spread his ideas and found a follower, Harriet Holton. His mother and brother then joined him, and he left to begin what is now known as the Oneida Community.
Hi. What's up, guys? So I was wondering if you guys wanted to join our community. We're starting a community. It's in Oneida, New York.
You'll have food to eat, and you never die.
What you call thyself?
My name is John R. Miller.
My name is John L. Skinner.
Hello. My name is Captain Noyes.
Captain Noyes today.
We're wondering if you wanted to come, because I can make that happen.
Come on here with us.
A lot.
Come on.
Yes.
Yes.
John Humphrey Noyes and his new recruits now traveled to Oneida, New York, where they could practice their strange religious beliefs in peace.
You'll never die.
John and friends finally arrived at Oneida, New York, despite losing their friend James on the way.
Shh. What is that?
I want to join your community. I like your doctrine.
We have a new member.
This is TJ Humphrey. Come.
to sit.
You know what I mean.
I can convert you, make you sinless.
Prove it.
What do you mean, prove it?
Do
what does that even mean in your language?
Do it.
No! Shh!
Listen,
shut up! I'm in the moment! I'm in the moment!
Your father
is
dead!
Just do it!
Shut me up!
I don't care!
I don't care!
What?
It says that he left us $20,000!
Yeah! I know what we can use this money for. We can finally establish our community! We can buy a house?
And so John did put that money to good use and establish the Oneida community. Meanwhile...
Where are we even going?
These two boys, William on the left and James on the right, are searching for their long-lost father, who may or may not be John Humphrey Noyes.
This must be the place! The place!
I don't know why you think that
William.
You could help me when you couldn't get by yourself. And I don't know who would ever wanna tell the seam of someone's dream. Baby, it's fine. You said that we should just be friends while I came up with that line. And I'm sure that it's for the best. If you ever change your mind, don't hold your breath. Cause you may not believe.
William, what are you doing?
I'm sorry for my brother, William. I'm James. Nice to meet you. Dude. Okay, nice to meet you. Anyway, we're looking for John Humphrey Noyes. Does he live here?
Yes.
Yes? Oh, awesome. Okay, could you tell me where he is?
He's not here right now.
Could you tell me, like, where he is, then?
He's not here right now.
Okay, that's somewhat helpful. Thank you. Let's go, William.
The boys interrupt their father and his newly gained members in the middle of a ritual.
John Humphrey Noyes!
Can I help you?
We got a letter from you.
A what? What are you doing? Stop.
He said a letter. We got a letter from... paper.
Mm-hmm. I summoned you here to be part of my community! Give me a hug!
Ah!
Woo! Alan!
What? Yep.
Alan!
Yeah.
Fuck yeah!
I don't really understand what was wrong with what I was wearing before, but if it's part of your tradition.
Hey, no, do not button it.
It's just a plain black.
Just let it all hang out.
What?
Let it all hang out.
I'm sorry.
Do you not understand what I'm saying?
I'm sorry, are you saying mout?
The man said, let it hang mout.
That's what I said.
I
let it hang shroud, as in the fish.
I think that.
You know what?
You mean
hug it. Hug him.
I think you're trying to say let it hang out.
That's hug him tight.
All
right. Do it.
Okay.
Hug him.
Give me a hug.
Tight.
Everyone take a seat.
I don't care. I don't. Do you care? You don't care?
I don't care.
Do you care?
No.
Why? Why care? What's your name, son?
George, I'm your brother.
What's your name?
George.
Loud and clear.
George.
George, do you care?
Yes. No. No.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
No.
What'd you say, George?
That's how much I don't care. I don't care!
Me neither.
Son, come! No, the good one.
Come on. We're doing this.
Father like son. I don't know what that means in this situation. We're nothing alike.
I'm gonna mutually criticize you.
Mutual criticism is an Oneida doctrine which states that any member of the community besides John Humphrey Noyes himself may approach another member of the community and start criticizing them for the purpose of bettering the community.
Do it. I want you to.
Do
you see that? That's a tear.
Nope, no tear.
I haven't cried in 15 years.
No, you're not actually
I haven't ever even cried when I was born.
You're not crying right now, and I don't believe
Shit,
that.
It's coming.
What?
I love you.
Do you say you love
I'm
me?
I'm sorry I left you.
No, you're not.
I've missed you all these years.
You definitely haven't. You wrote me a letter 17 years later, actually, so
it's happening.
What's happening?
I'm leaking. All right, good job. Very good. Very good criticism. Okay. If I can call to the stand the lovely Harriet Holton. Okay, we're gonna mutually criticize her, all right? You, go first.
You're just too fat, cellulite Sally.
Go!
You look like a pope.
Go!
I'm not gonna criticize
Why?
Her. I don't
Come
know.
Come on, Dad!
I'm not... You call me dad?
Yeah!
I'm not your dad!
She's fat!
Why are you...
Go!
How did you get shoes?
What did we learn today? What did we learn?
We are not sinful.
You are not sinful, no. Look at me, for example. I am the perfect human being.
Yeah.
I am so damn awesome. I've never sinned once in my life. And now I'm passing that on to you by being a part of the Oneida community. You are not a sinner. You are sinless. You are cleansed of your sins. I can ensure this. Welcome, my son. How does it feel now that you are no longer being held down by the terribleness of the world?
Feels good. Really glad to be here. It's kind of weird, gonna be honest.
All right, all original members of the community, and my son, come in the tent. Everyone else, practice the alphabet. Twice. All right, everyone. You know the drill. Elders on the right, virgins on the left. Hey, don't even think about it. Virgins. You two. Take the virgin side. You can learn a thing or two. All right. Elders. Choose your virgins. Mm-hmm. Shake hands with them. Greet them. Bring them. Go, quick!
Hey, dudes. Come with me, sir.
Ah, my dear Harriet, since you are my lovely bride, I believe you should take my son. Now, what we're going to practice is something called Ascending Fellowship. Everyone write that down in your mind. Not with a piece of paper and pencil. Ascending Fellowship. We have an elder and a virgin. The elder will teach the virgin the ways of the human body. We will also be practicing male countenance. What is that? Harriet, can you answer? Don't answer that, actually. Son, what is male countenance? Excuse me. We don't want to, you know, have, We don't like to continue our race, necessarily, so...
Only 40 children were ever born in the Oneida community.
It's our way of stopping it from...
Oh, okay. I think
Do
I
you
get
understand
it.
What
I... think I get it.
Holding it...
I think...
You
holding
don't
it
put
in,
the
in,
Jesus
okay.
juice in
just,
the bowl.
Thank you. I get it. Male continence.
You don't want them poking the bowl. It's
Who are you?
What?
Who is he? Who's that?
Son, boy.
Oh, son. Sorry about that. Okay, everyone, go!
Yeah!
Just let it happen, son. Come on, take it off. Just take it off.
No, I'd rather just take it. This. I think this is just your thing. This is your thing, Dad. We all got our things.
Come on, Dad.
Jane,
what?
Your father. I have very morbid news. Your father's dying.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes?
No!
That's a big deal.
No!
Yes.
No!
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 John!
What is that?
John, what is it? It's me, your son, James.
No! I'm dying!
What's wrong?
I'm dying!
No! John! Dad!
I'm gonna die, son!
What happened?
I was killed!
Wait, how were you killed?
I was killed by disease! What? I'm gonna die!
No, please!
I love you, son!
No! I love you so much, Dad.
I love you.
No.
I want to love you more than I love you.
No, please.
Just take the Oneida community. Take it from me.
No.
Do what you will with it.
No.
Please.
I can't. You're the leader. You started it.
I'm going to die now.
You started it. It's your game.
No.
James stayed in the community for 2 more months and really enjoyed himself. He even adopted all the doctrines. That was, until he received word that his father had passed away and left him in charge. At that moment, everyone realized how weird the whole community was and left.
Oh, how did you get out of your cage? Get back in!